Right, this is the Star Wars review that we've been promising you all this time. I'm Joseph, as usual. I usually review these, but I'm introducing
the core
here to review the films. Now, what we're going to be reviewing is the original Star Wars trilogy, the original three films.
Actually, I'm afraid I have to stop you there, Joe. I'm afraid I've got a little something for you.
What's this?
I'm afraid we're going to be reviewing the 2011 Blu-ray release of the complete saga, so I'm afraid we'll be watching the prequels as well.
Oh,
all six films.
Yeah, we're going to be talking about our feelings on this. Is a re-release, the 2011 Blu-ray re-release. As we expected, George Lucas has messed with them again. I've left it at least 2.5 years before I even bought these because I was so put off getting them. I don't know why he keeps doing it. Well, we do really. Money, basically. But
I mean, this was, what, £47?
Yeah, and that was the cheapest I could get it for. So
what's the recommended retail price?
Like 100 quid or something. No, it's about 70, I think, something like that. But
so, yeah, £70.
Probably about in America.
Is it worth it?
Yeah, not really. But the original trilogy, like I said, they've kind of cleaned the picture up a bit, as you would expect, but also they've kind of tweaked certain things. Not really done a lot of stuff. There's quite a lot of deleted scenes, but they haven't really incorporated them back into the film. You can view a lot of deleted scenes on the extras, which I might get through each film individually as we go through it, but they've just kind of done some more special effects and stuff. So it doesn't really enhance the film in any way in terms of like plot or, you know, content or anything like that.
Okay, we've just seen episode one.
Phantom Menace. Released in 1999 originally. Like I said, this is the 2011 re-release. So what are your feelings?
Well, I would try and give like an episode synopsis of this, but the more you look at it, the less sense the plot actually makes. So it was alright. I didn't like have to suffer to watch it. I didn't feel like I was like giving up like an hour and whatever of my life or anything.
I think this is my least favourite of the original prequel trilogy. It was the biggest letdown, because I think up till that point we didn't really know what to expect, because our standards were fairly like kind of high, because it was based on the original trilogy. And all throughout the 90s, being, you know, a kid, we were like, what, 18 by the time this film came out? So
more or less, yeah.
So for pretty much the 5 years leading up to this, from the mid-90s up till when it came out in 99, we had this expectation. It had been so built up and hyped up. And, you know, we just expected it to be really good, and it was like, we just saw it and we're like, huh? You know, kind of thing.
Well, I know I've always had like a bit of an aversion to prequels. I just don't really like them very much as a form of filmmaking. If there's anything we really needed to know back then, you should have included it in your film, not, you know, you have to now go back and retell it. But even saying that, I was stoked to see this when it came out of the cinema. And like you said, it was very
It was anticlimactic, I think, is the word that I've really probably used as well. Because a lot of people said, like, oh, I've got doubts it's going to be any good. And I was like, of course, you know, it causes me good. It's not, how could they possibly mess this up, you know?
I mean, it's George Lucas. He's the guy who created it. He's not going to, like, make a mess of this.
Yeah, wrong.
Dead wrong.
But I mean, like I've always said, you know, what I imagined before I saw the prequels, what I imagined happened, you know, in those unmade films at the time, what I imagined was actually better than the films, kind of thing. It was pretty bad that they couldn't. It was, you know, it was by far a disappointment, basically. But like I say, we're kind of focusing on Phantom Menace because that's the one we just watched. In terms of differences, anyway, on the Blu-ray, what did you really notice?
Very little. I think you said they've like CGI'd Yoda rather than using a puppet.
Yeah, do you want to just elaborate on like your feelings on that?
I'm kind of ambivalent towards it because it does add like continuity with the other films. He's kind of the same all the way through the prequels now. I think if they replace the puppet in like the original trilogy as well, I'm just going to riot.
Yeah, we're switching them off.
Yes.
They haven't, no, I know they haven't, but yeah, if they had, that would have been pretty bad. But no, I mean, it looks alright in terms of like standard to the rest of them, but there were a couple of bits where there's like the bit at the end where he's talking to Obi-Wan Kenobi right at the end of the film.
And yeah, and Obi-Wan looks to be like peering very intently at his ear.
Yeah.
Just kind of looking somewhere here when Yoda's clearly here.
Yeah, they didn't line it up properly, but... yeah, I mean, there's a lot of stuff like that in these films. The CGI really, even at the time, it didn't look all that great. It didn't look realistic, you know. I mean, I think they were going for like what Spielberg had done with Jurassic Park. I mean, obviously it's made by the same, like a lot of the same people in terms of special effects, but Jurassic Park did a lot better job. But I think it's just very bland and very kind of... unemotional kind of set pieces, because it's all done on a computer basically. You know that the actors are just talking to somebody holding up a tennis ball on a green screen,
which would be more entertaining than Jar Jar.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, Jar Jar, I'm not gonna get started. But no,
I mean, in some ways I do think the as a racist stereotype, he isn't really, yeah, he's got like a, I mean, he's clearly like a black guy doing the voice, but more like a gay stereotype, kind of really gay and kind of
gay Rastafarian and... stereotype.
Yeah, kind of.
Jonathan Ross said in an interview once, but it's definitely true. But no, I mean, Jar Jar is just basically like kind of Lucas's equivalent of Scooby Doo, you know, and it just doesn't.
Scooby Doo would have been less annoying.
Yeah, that would have been quite funny to see Scooby Doo, like, you know, fighting.
And I'd have gotten away with it if it wasn't for those damn Jedi.
Exactly, yeah.
I've just stolen his joke, though.
Yeah, I know. But no, in terms of, like, say, again, the picture quality on Blu-ray, I'm not a big, massive, you know, fan of the, you know, the difference between DVD and Blu-ray. I don't really see
much. Maybe if you had it on, like, a huge TV, but honestly, just watching it, if I didn't know this was the Blu-ray edition, I would have just, like, assumed this was the DVD edition.
Yeah, exactly.
Like I said, there's no actual differences, there's no extra scenes and no extra special effects. This is pretty much... as you would get it on DVD, it's just they've gone back and they've CGI'd Yoda instead of having a puppet.
Yeah, there wasn't. I've read online there's a few little differences, but it's like they'll have somebody in the background, like a bit of extra like background noise or something. And it's like,
yeah, there's nothing that I noticed.
Exactly.
Another problem with this film is, of course, Anakin Skywalker. Sorry.
Yeah.
Having him as a little kid was a serious misstep. It removes him as a possible, like, hero for the story for you to follow, because he's just a slightly annoying, kind of wooden little kid. It completely derails any kind of foreshadowing for the romance, because even in the scenes when they're together, it's clear that he's a little kid and she's, like, in her 20s. Just, like, you know, starting out in her 20s. And any kind of interaction she has, it's like, oh, there you are, you're cold, let me just, like, you know, put, like, a blanket round you kind of thing.
That's a towel, dude.
Well, yeah, I know. You know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
It's not like we had a prop ready.
Yeah, I'm going to say.
But you know what I mean? It's not... there's no romance there. He doesn't interact with Obi-Wan at all. So there's no, establishment of, like, this great friendship the two of them are supposed to have.
Yeah.
Spoiler if you haven't seen the prequels, and well, pretty much everybody has, but... there's no sign these two were ever friends.
Yeah, it's kind
there's barely an indication the two of them well. Like each other, let alone are friends.
Yeah, especially in 2 and 3, it's kind of a dick to him. But talking about the Blu-ray differences, extra features is not a right lot. To be honest, I haven't been through the whole thing. There's documentaries which kind of... the ones on the original films are kind of interesting, but...
the ones on the prequels just tend to rub me up the wrong way, because it's like Lucas being like, it's like poetry, it's like... it's like it all fits together, like a fine.
Every stanza rhymes with each other.
Again, it's like poetry, so if they rhyme, every stanza kind of rhymes with the last one. Hopefully it'll work.
Yeah. It's like, no it isn't, it's crap.
Yeah.
You haven't thought your plot through properly. The more you think about it, the less sense it makes.
Yeah.
Some of the deleted scenes were kind of interesting. The ones on Naboo were crap. However, the ones on Tatooine were actually kind of interesting, I think. There's like an extended bit of a fight between Qui-Gon and
Darth Maul.
Darth Maul, which I actually wish they'd left in the film, because if the effect was finished, I think it looked quite good.
Yeah, it was only like a few seconds though, but it was pretty good.
And there's an extended argument between Watto and Qui-Gon about trying to get Shmi Skywalker as well as Anakin Skywalker freed.
Yeah.
Which makes him appear a little bit more human, a little bit more like he cares.
Yeah.
But certainly on the strength of this thing, I won't go running out to get it on Blu-ray just for these extra features.
Yeah.
I seem to remember the DVD version which you've got there is filled with special features and making of documentaries and things.
That aren't on this. So there's a lot of deleted scenes on the DVD that aren't even on the Blu-ray. As far as I could see, I couldn't find them anyway. It's kind of a difficult thing to navigate as well.
What were the kind of special features like on that? The deleted scenes like
deleted scenes is like a bit where Anakin Skywalker is fighting with what turns out to be Greedo.
What's this all about?
He said I cheated.
Did you?
No.
Do you still think he cheated?
Igwa.
Well, Annie, you know the truth. You'll just have to tolerate his opinion. Fighting will not change it.
Yeah, I thought that was actually in the film. No. But I can't remember seeing it this time.
It was an extra feature on the original DVD, but I can't find it anywhere on the Blu-ray discs.
Then again, it's a very stupid scene, because did we really need foreshadowing for Greedo?
Well, yeah, but just the principle that, you know, like, excluding him.
And also, it kind of takes away a little bit from the original film, because you get the impression he's a bounty hunter who's been, like, stalking Solo.
Yeah.
Not just he's a bum that lives on Tatooine and just happens to have stumbled across him.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. So it kind of makes him, you know, like he's there on Tatooine or something, like he's a local or something. Anyway, well, I better wrap this up because we're coming to end of, you know, we could ramble on about this film all day and it would just be us bickering about it.
It's not terrible. It's not my least favourite film of all time or anything, but the plot doesn't make sense. The character motivations don't really make sense. The direction is terrible.
It's just weak. The acting, I mean, Ewan McGregor's a good actor, but his bits in this are pretty shocking, you know.
So. Well, I mean, Qui-Gon Jinn is also, he doesn't really do much.
Yeah.
And really, the guy's a much better actor than that.
Yeah. Anyway, right, we'll wrap this up. We're going to watch episode 2 next, then we're going to review the film afterwards and again talk about the differences between the DVD and the Blu-ray and what we thought about it, what we thought about the film in general. So check back for part 2. Nothing else to add?
Nope.
No, thank you very much.